don't miss any content, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Hey guys, welcome back to Sahara Football. As usual, I am your host, Salasi Fiawe. Today, we have some interesting piece of information for you. We're going to talk about Coach CK Akono. He is in Europe to visit some of the Ghanaian players, and he met with captain of the side, Andre Ayew, with his brother, Jordan Ayew, on Sunday morning. More information coming there for you. Now, FIFA wants Africa to host the African Cup of Nations every 4 years instead of 2 years. What do you think about that? We'll be delving into that and the proposal by Gianni Infantino and why he is proposing that in the first place. Also, we'll look at Kotoko's young star, that is Matthew Cudjoe, the 16-year-old prodigy who is doing amazing stuff in the Ghana Premier League. Well, he's in the Ghana Premier League no longer. He's now left Ghana for Germany. He is with the Bayern Munich and he will be doing his trials there with the under 19 side. Amazing times for the young star. We wish him the very best in the end. I'll be giving you more details on that. As usual, if you're new to the channel, I advise you to subscribe to the channel and to click on the notification bell to get more updates. So we all know Coach CK Akono. If you listen to his first speech as the coach of the Ghana Black Stars, up here you can watch it. He said that he will be going to Europe to familiarize himself with some of the players, starting with the captain of the side, Andre Ayew, in Wales. He was there over the weekend and he had a nice chat with the captain of the side along with his brother Jordan Ayew. So the Black Stars coach CK Akono has started his European tour visiting Ghanaian players by calling on the Black Stars captain Andre Ayew in Wales. Now the Black Stars coach, whose itinerary for the United Kingdom includes visiting other players in England, was fortunate to have Jordan visiting his brother in Wales. So he seized the opportunity to have discussions with both players. The discussions centered on the coach's vision, program and new direction for the national team. Now Andre expressed delight over the meeting and said it is an honor for the coach to visit. He has been there before as a captain and understands the situation of wanting to do well for not only us but for all Ghanaians. We have had a great meeting. We have a double header coming up and it is good that we win and secure qualification in our quest to bring back the African Cup. CK Akono will pay similar visits to other Ghanaian players in England, Spain and Germany in the coming days. He will also take the opportunity of his European tour to have a closer look at some players of Ghanaian origin. While in England, Germany and Spain, Coach CK Akono will also have technical discussions with coaches at Leicester City, his former club Wolfsburg and FC Barcelona. His first assignment will be in March. We'll have a double header AFCON 2021 qualifier against Sudan to look forward to. So Ghana will be facing Sudan in March. The latter stages of March will be facing Sudan here in Ghana and also in Sudan Khartoum. So many, it will be a great clash to look forward to, but it's interesting and amazing that the Black Stars, great move from the Black Stars coach to familiarize himself with the squad and talk about his ways forward. I'm sure it was a fruitful meeting with the captain. We hope it helps the Black Stars secure their first ever AFCON trophy since 1982. Let me know your thoughts in the comments box on this. Do you think CK Akono will be successful as Black Stars coach? Your thoughts are welcome in the comments box. I move on to my next story. It has to do with the African Cup of Nations, which Ghana is looking to secure for the first time since 1982. Now, Gianni Infantino, the president of FIFA, is suggesting that the African Cup of Nations be held every 4 years, as that is the case with other major tournaments. Now, the African Cup of Nations tournament should be played every 4 years instead of two, according to Gianni Infantino. Infantino said revenue could rise up to sixfold for a four-yearly continental championship and become a must-see event, not only for Africa, but for the world. Now, the FIFA president also tempted African officials with the prospect of more entries in an expanded state of Youth World Cups. Infantino suggested annually under 16 and under 18 tournaments for boys and girls instead of the current under 17 events every 2 years. Now, the boys tournament could grow to 24 teams, girls tournament could grow to 24 teams from 16. Infantino's comment came in a keynote speech at a conference in Sale, Morocco, on developing African football and also enclosing widening gap between Europeans' dominance of the world game. This is what he said. There is an impression that Africa is going backwards, he said, reminding his audience of Pele's famous prediction that an African team would win the World Cup by 2000. Africa's five teams at the 2018 World Cup made it out of the group stages, and Africa has had three quarterfinals in World Cup history, though none reached the semis. We have to intervene seriously, Infantino said. FIFA's role to help Africa in the areas of refereeing, football infrastructure, and competitions. FIFA has effectively run the troubled CAF for the past 6 months. Infantino sent his Senegalese Secretary General Fatima Samoura from Zurich to oversee the Cairo-based CAF. In January, a FIFA-influenced decision annoyed European football officials by switching the month-long African Cup of Nations from June 2021 to January. The cited reason was rainy season in Cameroon, though it also cleared a space in football's crowded calendar for FIFA's inaugural 2014 Club World Cup, kicking off in the same month in China. The competitions don't give us what they should give us, Infantino said Saturday, arguing for the change. He said African Cup of Nations could be in January or June, depending on the weather conditions. On refereeing, Infantino said 20 of Africa's best match officials could be employed by FIFA on professional contracts to improve the credibility of the continent's football across the board. And Gianni Infantino once again interfering in African football. Now, FIFA have sent Fatima Samoura to take over the running of African football here. And CAF are really, really under some serious pressure. Now, first of all, it was the changing of the dates for the African Cup of Nations from June, which we all have to agree we enjoy, now to January 2021 to accommodate for a Club World Cup. That is quite unfortunate. They stated weather conditions, but I highly doubt the weather conditions would have been so terrible for a tournament to take place. And it happened in June last year, just last year. And this time, Cameroon are saying the weather conditions will be that bad. Now, CAF, FIFA, whoever is in charge now, I don't know whether CAF authorities are in charge now, but they are suggesting also that we move the African Cup of Nations to every 4 years, and it will increase the commercial value of the African Cup of Nations, according to the FIFA president. The problem of the African Cup of Nations, I don't think, is the duration of the years. It is the time it is played. Last year, when it was played in June, July, it was really an amazing tournament. We all enjoyed it. The world was focused on it. Now, even if the African Cup of Nations is played in January, when club football is actively going on, it's not about the 4 years or 3 years or 2 years or whatever. It's about the time it is played. It is played in January, not in the summer all the time. And when we got the summer one, we all saw how improved it was. Let me know your thoughts, guys. I feel it is a wrong move. The way we should have done it was played it in June throughout. It doesn't matter the number of years you wait to play the African Cup of Nations. It is the timing that is more important. It should have been placed in June. It's as simple as that, not the duration of the years. That's my two cents there on that issue. Let me know yours in the comments box. To my final story, it has to do with Matthew Cudjoe, Kumasi Asante Kotoko, Wonder Boy Matthew Cudjoe. He has left the shores of Ghana to play with the under 19 in Bayern Munich in Germany. Now, the 16-year-old will train with the Bavarians under 19, which is coached by ex-Germany striker Miroslav Klose. Cudjoe was observed by Bayern for months, but his enchanting second half display in the Ghana Premier League derby last month quickened his move to Germany. Bayern Munich will be seeking to sign him on other stellar European sides, including PSG, have expressed interest. He made his debut in the second week of the season against Legon Cities in Accra and scored his first league goal against Ebusia Dwarfs at home. Cudjoe was discovered during the maiden edition of Baby Jet Under 16 tournament in 2018, a competition curated by Black Stars captain and striker Asamoah Gyan. So, Baby Jet Asamoah Gyan's prodigy a young starlet in the making. Can he thrive at Bayern Munich? Will he make the trials? Let me know your thoughts in the comment box on his move to Germany. He has left the shores of Ghana and going to take part in the trials. Your thoughts are welcome on that. Wish him the very best, and we hope he does supremely well and comes back to Ghana to help the national team. So that has been it for today, guys. I've been talking to you about Gianni Infantino suggesting that the African Cup of Nations be switched to 4 years instead of 2 years. Also, we've been talking about Matthew Cujo, the 16-year-old making the waves in the Ghana Premier League. He has left the shores of Ghana for Germany. Also, Sike Akono paid a visit to the captain and his brother Jordan Ayew, and to discuss the future of the Black Stars as we prepare to face Sudan in a doubleheader in March. Let me know your thoughts in everything. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.